What is OER? Okay, in UMS we have two kinds of repositories. One repository is maintained by the library, which stores all your publications from Springer and all those publishers which are publishing. Okay, that's a repository. The other repository is basically what we have in UMS, which stores your open educational resources. So these slides, right, this lecture note actually becomes part of the OER. Now, when you store it on OER, remember two things will happen. One, the first thing which will happen is that it will get a URL. So it becomes a publication which is not peer reviewed. It's actually a publication online because it has a URL and it has a link on the server. Secondly, your content is searchable on Google. Okay, you can find it on Google. I will show you how this is the OER repository. So once you, if you need to upload here, right, you need to open an account here. So how do you open an account? You give your name to Zul. Zulfadli, okay? You give your name, he's the admin for this. He will assign you an account for your specific email. It's linked to your UMS mail. Okay, but you need permission from Zul, right? You have permission, right? He has it. You cannot create it. You need to email Zul. Zul will create it for you. Okay, that's the procedure. You can register it here. You register. Yeah, you register here. You register here. You register here, it will create for you and you click your email. Okay? He will take some time because they are working, so by evening maybe we will access, or tomorrow morning you will see your account created here. Because cannot upload. So Zul, maybe we check later when we go to this online. Dennis, after Dennis. Dennis, it is Dennis underscore L. What is yours?
Dennis
ADL. ADL. So he can see your. Okay, we'll do this as the time goes by, but I will show you that the OER actually exists. Yeah, maybe Dr. Dan is not assigned. We are trying to get everyone enrolled in OER to basically give you more exposure to. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, sorry. Yes, yes, that means. Actually, the caveat is officially we cannot do that. Officially, because it is infringing the copyrights of that publisher. Unless you have permission from that publisher. Usually you can write to the publisher. What will happen in this situation, you can write to the publisher and get an email from them saying you can use it for commercial, for teaching use. They will usually give. Okay. E-N-I-S.
E-N-I-S.
Sini ada.
Yeah.
Okay, we will do this for you. We went into all this because we need you all to be, I want you all to be aware of all these stuffs. Otherwise, I don't want to. Okay, so you can give them later. We'll collect your email and we'll register. I'll just briefly show you how you protect your material. Okay, Zul, we can go to the main page. Main page. Go to the, just go to the home page. Just go to the home. We see the main page. Main page. Okay, so this is basically the home page. Okay, this is the home page of the OER repository. So you, once you upload it, you will basically see your content here. Okay, for uploading, we have a tutorial. We can share the tutorial with you. It's a video tutorial which shows you what to click on. So it's a video which tells you click, click, click and upload here. Okay, so I will show you an example of this. Go to the faculty of FKSW, right? FKSW, we go to, Where is the, go to the F, the FKSW. Yeah, FKSW is here, so click here. Okay. So, sorry? Yeah, yeah, can. You can use, the, you can upload the link for YouTube here. Yeah, you can upload every YouTube you create, you can click. Okay, click on e-magazines. Okay, now what FKSW has done is a very nice thing. They have actually uploaded, go to the one about the photo communication here. Oh, this one you can also. Yeah, so what they have done, right, inside the repository, I'll give you Chanto example of that. What they have done is they have, their students have created reports. The report they have actually converted into a PDF and uploaded here. So the report itself becomes a teaching and learning material. So you can click, it'll upload. Click the, cannot open, can open, image. Okay, you open the image, view open. Okay, so they have the system inside. So I'm telling you this because each and every report which our student creates can be actually become a material here, provided that they complied with the condition, which is they did not use copyrighted material, and you cited all of them. So if you have six students in a group and you upload them here, please, when you register in the system, please register all your students. Student cannot upload here. Only the lecturer can upload. Okay. So if you have 40 reports in one semester, you can upload 40 reports and they become 40 content in the OER, all attributed to you and your students. Okay. So it's a big, you can basically use all reports. Only thing, make sure the students don't put in copyrighted material and they don't have any kind of plagiarism inside. You need to do a plagiarism check, because if it's plagiarized content in a repository, it can lead to other issues. Okay, so they have created this inside and they upload. I think the lecturer uploaded the student report. Okay, student reports with the gambar, everything you can put up here, but make sure the material is not plagiarized and not copyrighted inside. Then you upload here. It's already automatically get the license. Yeah. Yeah.
My course is marriage and family.
Okay.
So I can use that.
Yeah. Okay. So for video, it works like this, doctor. So first, you take the video, right? They are taking the video. Where do they deposit the video? In YouTube?
No, they have to make on their own.
Okay. Yes. But after they create the video, where do they like?
Yeah, they upload to the YouTube.
YouTube. Okay. Okay. See. Okay. This is another thing which now you mentioned. Very good. You raised the point. Okay. In the video, are they interviewing other people? Is there an interview, like a Tamil Duga, like a interview?
Are there, right?
Okay. So basically like this. So this is, again, I'm telling you, it's good that you raised this point about interview. When you do an interview with the, for example, I'm audience, right? Your student come and interview. I'm not a staff of UMS. I'm some, just the public. What happens is that you need to get permission from that person for the video. It's very, very important. Yeah,
it's okay.
If they have given permission to that person, so please keep this in mind, because if they upload the video to YouTube, tomorrow they can say, oh, you use our picture for YouTube, and then that creates a bigger problem for us, the lecturer, because they will say, so okay, you can upload the video on YouTube, right? In this system, you can insert the link for YouTube. Okay, I have prepared a video tutorial step by step guiding how to do it. I can share, Zul can share it with Mr. Amin, and I'll share in your group. Okay, it tells you how to do the video upload step by step. So you can put in the link, put in a PDF, and then it's basically going to attribute to you. Okay, and these videos are searchable then on Google. You can search it on Google, and if you do the setting, it will link to your Google Scholar account. Okay, so these are things. I will show you very, very simple. I will show you what I did. Okay, go Abzul to mine IPB, go to this. Okay, so I'll show you an example of how it's done. Okay, so this is a report. Okay, so this is e-note, right? What is that? E-note, right? Click e-note. I show you just, okay, click here. Okay, view open. Yeah. Okay, so this is, I created a e-note for the student. It's a technical material for them to distribute during the lecture. It designs, it's basically content, but can you see what I did on top? I create the license. So the license is embedded in the PDF note. So the student downloaded, the license is carried with the PDF note. Okay. When you all, if you all attend IDP course on Creative Commons attribution, we will show you how to create this kind of note. So once the note is inside, it's searchable on Google. So it adds to your citation, even add to your Google Scholar as an article. I wanted to see whether PPI will accept. So when I do our PPI, the system, right, SMPPI, I keyed it in and I put the link, they accept, they verify, which means it will work for everybody else. I already tried it out. So you just put it up, you convert your e-note, you put it here, because the link is there, and this link is connected to a global repository. So PPI automatically accept as a publication which is not indexed. It will come up. Actually, this time, because I'm doing the admin duty, I only have one publication from Scopus, and the remaining five are they're like this. But I still got full marks. Means, actually, I should have three publications from Scopus according to KPI, but I only have one. But the remaining is from here. The ELNPT shows full marks, so that means it's recognizing this thing as well. Okay, so use it for your benefit and for protecting your content. So this is the way you use. Okay, so if you want to, we will be conducting one IDP course. It's 1 day for OER system use. So you can find in the BSM website for this. Okay, so you close. So close. Okay, so this is the way you use images. So coming back to our image search. Okay, so I have shown you all basically how to use the image in the system. Now we'll.